In this overview, we'll show you the highlights of using data management to load source system data by file into a sample planning and budgeting cloud application, and then drill through to the source system. You'll perform the following steps to load data by file. If you import the same data regularly, you need only perform these steps once. In the source system, generate a delimited or fixed format file that identifies the source data to load. The file must also contain the data that you need to access the source system drill landing page, where you can drill through to the source system. We include the eBusiness Suite period and code combination ID, also called the CC ID, to drill through to eBusiness. Although you need the CC ID and period to drill down, they aren't required just to load data by file into a target application. Next, confirm that the sample planning and budgeting cloud application is defined in data management, and define an import format containing the source system drill URL. Last, map dimensions in the load file to target dimensions in the application, and then create and run a data load rule to load the data. Let's explore this process and use data management to import trial balances into a sample application called Vision, and then we'll drill through to the eBusiness Suite source system. On target application, we can see that Vision is set up and that we can connect. Then we can use import format to specify the drill URL to access eBusiness Suite, identify Vision as our target, and then map data in the load file fields to target dimensions. The drill URL must contain the attributes needed to identify and access the source system data that you'll drill down on, in addition to the account, amount, entity, period, and version. For eBusiness Suite, this means including the attributes that correspond to the CC ID and period for the source system ledger. Next, we can define a location so that we can associate our import format with Vision, and to group related mappings and data load rules. We can use data load mappings to map dimension members in the data load file to target dimensions, and to review how source values will transform into target values in the application. On data load rule, we identify the source data to load and map using the point of view at the bottom of the page. We can choose a location, a period, and a category, such as actuals for January 2012. Then we can create a load rule to specify the source and target options for the trial balances data load file, and then run the rule, making sure to select import from source so that we can review the source data and mapped results in the workbench. Here, we can see the actual cash account values from January 2012 that we'll export to Vision. We can also see their mapped values in Vision. Amounts for these accounts will be loaded once we click Export. Notice the value for account 1110. Now let's open Vision and view our loaded data, noticing the correct value for account 1110. Because we use data management to load data by file, we can drill down to access varying levels of detail. We can drill through to the landing page where we can get an account summary, and also access the data load file, and we can drill through to the source system, logging on to Enterprise Business Suite to view journal details, subledger details, and additional information about the data that we loaded. In this overview, we showed you the highlights of using data management to load data by file and then drill through to the source. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.